quadrotor. In this exercise, we propose a modelization, a simulation, and the control of a quadrotor. The quadrotor represented here has four blades. 1, 2, 3, 4. The first one is on the right and has a rotational speed of omega 1. And as we can see here, the rotational speed, this one, and the third one, so opposite direction, are the same, but are different from the second and the fourth blade, just to have some equilibrium. Indeed, when a blade turns in one direction, as a counter reaction, the quadrotor will want to turn on the other direction. This quadrotor has some state variable. It will correspond, so the state vector x will be of dimension 12. Why? Because we have 6 degrees of freedom. So we'll have x, y, and z correspond to the position of the center of gravity, the center of quadrotor, and x is oriented forward, so here, forward. It has also the Euler angle, so the Euler angle will correspond to psi theta phi, roll pitch psi theta phi, or phi theta psi. And you will have also the derivative of this quantity. That's why we have a state vector of dimension 12. 6 degrees of freedom, 6, and their derivative. So their derivative correspond here to the speed, so v. So it's a vector of dimension 3, and I will take it in because we can much more easy, but I could have taken the speed in the absolute frame. So this one, the word frame, x, y, and z represented here. So here I will have the frame of the word. And if z here, x here, and y here corresponds to the frame in the robot space. So here I will consider the speed in the robot frame. I could have also considered in the world frame R0. And for the derivative of the Euler angle, I will consider omega, the vectors, the rotational vectors omega R, also represented in the robot frame. So let me try to give some more explanation on this. So the state vector, and we'll try to show this, are given here. So here P corresponds to x, y, and z, the position of the quadrotor. The derivative of the Euler angle are given here. So let me recall that when I want to modelize a system, I obtain, I try to have the form, a state equation, x, which is a function, x dot is a function of the state x and the input u. So the input u in my context, it will correspond to the rotation omega 1, omega 2, omega 4 of the blades, and x will be in my situation of dimension 12 and will correspond to the degree of freedom of my robot, so here the position and the Euler angle, but their derivative. So most of the time when I have what we say holonomous robot, the state vector corresponds to the degree of freedom and their derivative, and it is the case here. I will try to for the simulation, I will have first to draw my system, and I will start with a Python program which is given here. So I will draw a quadrilateral corresponding to the state X. So here capital X, not to make a confusion with probably the X, Y and Z, the position variable of the robot, but I can put also a small one here. I made a loop just to draw the picture, and I will change the state. So most of the time, in practice, I have to obey to state equation. But here, just for simplicity, just to draw the quadrotor, I will modify the state. So here, I do not modify it. So in this case, the loop will not modify the state. So if I start it, you can see the robot here. Excuse me, execute. So it is represented here, and we can see that it does not move. I will remove this one, and if I want it to move, let's say, with respect to front, so x, I will modify the first state variable, and which corresponds to x, and it will go in the forward. So I run it, so we can see here that it is moving with respect to the blue, so maybe it's not long enough. I will, let's say, 10 seconds, and I will go faster, let's set 5, and we can see that it moves forward with respect to the blue, so the front, and it moves forward. Okay, so if now I want to move on the left, so maybe 5, it will be enough. So if I want to move with respect to Y, so I will check all of them, so let's say 3. So I check all my state variables just to be able to check that my drawing is correct, so I move with respect to the green one, to the Y direction. The same for Z. Since it is oriented downward, we can see that it goes down. So the black corresponds to the shadow, just to have a better three-dimensional view. And I will do the same with the earlier angle. So the first one with respect to rotation, with respect to X. Okay. I made a mistake. No, not this one. Excuse me, I have to modify the first one. And we'll see, turning with respect to X. Okay. So it is turning. The same, the rotation with respect to the second earlier angle. Okay. And I can do also the same with the third one. Okay, so I have a confusion because the shadow corresponds. So if I wanted to avoid this, let's say I will put it at minus 5. Okay, we have a better view here. Okay, so I have everything good now for the picture of my robot. And to simulate it, I first have to get the right state equation. So concerning the state equation, I have here the position of the robot, so P, which can be obtained from the speed. So I have here the speed of the robot. So the, if I draw, for instance, the speed of the robot in this direction, this corresponds to, let's say, VR. So R me in the frame of the robot. So it is the speed of the vector, and it can be represented either in R0. So in this case, the speed will be called, correspond to the derivative of P, so P dot. And if I represent it in R1, so in the frame of the robot, it will be denoted by VR. So this one and this one correspond to the same vector, but this one in R1, this one in R0, the word frame. And one is related to another thanks to the rotational matrix, where phi theta psi, the Euler angle, are involved. Okay. Now, I have also the derivative of the Euler angle, so phi theta psi, are related to the rotational speed vector, so omega r. Omega r, for instance, if omega r is like this, it means, so omega r, r means represented in the R1, it means that the quadrotor is turning around this vector with the rotational speed corresponding to the norm of omega r. So we can understand that this one and the derivative of the Euler angles are linked thanks to this matrix. So let me recall a few things about the inertial unit represented here. So inertial unit, which can be applied to any rigid body, not only a quadrotor. So I consider here a rigid body. This rigid body can has its own frame, for instance x, y and z. And here I have the word frame x, y and z, R0, R1. And this body is equipped with some sensors. So it is able to measure some acceleration. Let's say if it accelerates with respect to x, the vector will be something like this. And it will be able to measure so its acceleration in its own frame, but also its rotational speed. I will call it omega r, also in its own frame. So it is able to measure with inertial sensor its acceleration, and thanks to gyroscope, the rotational speed vector in its own frame. That's why I put R. Now, thanks to this state equation, I will be able to estimate using, for instance, a Runge-Kutta method or Euler method, an integration method. I have the derivative of some state variable here with respect to the state variable themselves, but also the input AR and omega R. So by integration, I will be able to obtain this quantity, the Euler angles, but also the speed and the position. And this corresponds to the principle of inertial central. It can be applied to any rigid body. And we can see here that this equation is also this equation here. This equation is here. And this equation is here. Okay. So if you prefer, this, if I call this So it will correspond to AR. Here I have AR. And we can see that this equation of the quadrirotor correspond to a classical inertial unit. So of course I need to show, to prove now this, to prove that AR corresponds to this, and the last equation which makes me possible to move, to create the rotation. So well, first I have to explain what means the tau here, and tau 1, tau 2, tau 3 that are introduced here. To do this, I will come back to my quadrirotor, and I just have to observe that the rotational speed create some forces or create some torques. So if we can see that each rotation create a force in this direction, more or less big, if you want. Okay. This, if I have a blade, so I will represent a blade like this, turning, for instance, like this. So if you want the rotational speed corresponds, the vector will correspond to this. For instance, if it is omega 3, it corresponds to omega 3 here and represented here. Then if the force, if you want, I will call it F3 for a while, so it will oriented toward this direction, for instance, and F3 will be proportional, let's say beta, times omega 1 multiplied by omega 1, the absolute value. So it corresponds to the square of omega 1, but normally we cannot write it because it can be negative. If I turn on the other direction, then I will obtain a force in downward. So that's why I need to put a sign, and I'm not able to put omega 1 square, or excuse me, omega 3 square in this situation, but it's an algebraic square. That's why the global force, or what we call the total thrust, corresponds, so I call it tau 0, corresponds to beta omega 1 multiplied by omega 1 absolute value, the due to this force, plus so on, plus omega 4 multiplied by omega 4 absolute value. It is the first one I have. Now, beta is called the thrust factor. Now, we can see that there is some not only a force, but also some torques. So if I consider here this x direction, and we can understand that omega 1 and omega 3 are involved in the rotation with respect to the x direction. Oh, that's why I will be able to write tau, the second one, so I will call it okay, with respect to direction number 1, so I will call it tau 1, which corresponds to something will be related to omega 1 multiplied so something like this, plus a coefficient. So this coefficient and also will be involved omega 3 multiplied by omega 3. I will have a coefficient, so this one will be involved negatively because it corresponds to not the positive direction. So minus something which will be proportional to beta, the same as this one, proportional to the force, but also to the distance to the center. So if I will represent the distance corresponds to this, I will call it L. So L is here, plus beta L. In the same manner, with respect to Y, positive direction will be like this, and I will have a torque, I will call it tau 2, because the second direction, and the last one, like this, corresponds to tau 3. So about tau 2, it's quite similar to tau 1. It will be involved only this propeller and also this propeller, and I will have tau 2, which corresponds to minus beta L multiplied by omega 2 square, algebraic square, and the other one on the other direction, beta L omega 4 multiplied by absolute value of omega 4. Okay. Excuse me. The positive direction is not like this. It is like this, of course. That's why here I have minus and here plus. And what about the third one? Since each blade, when they turn, they provoke a counter reaction of the body, and since they turn in opposite direction, I will have theta 3, which be equal to a coefficient, so I will call it delta, and delta will correspond to the drag factor, so it will be minus delta times omega 1 omega 1. I will have plus delta omega 2 omega 2 minus delta omega 3 omega 3 plus delta omega 4 omega 4. If I represent all this in a matrix form, I obtain this equation. So it means that in my quadrotor, I have a relation which tells me if my blade turn with some speeds given by omega A, then I will create a force, so the global force, the total thrust, and also I will obtain, so tau 1, tau 2, tau 3, which corresponds to torques. This one, it will correspond to the total force. Okay, so now I am able from the speed to generate the torque. How can I get from forces acceleration or rotation speed? I obtain using the second Newton formula or the Euler formula. So the Newton second law tells me that m, the mass of my quadrotor, multiplied by its acceleration, is equal to the sum of all forces. So the sum of all forces in my body, so if I have my quadrator, let's say like this, the forces, I will have something which corresponds to tau zero, but I will have also the weight. The weight will correspond to mj, and tau zero is here, and the mass. If I represent all in the robot frame, so in R1, the robot frame, I will have here A represented in R1, my weight will correspond to 0, 0 mj, because I recall that the orientation is z downward, that's why it's positive, multiply by, so I have to transform by the rotation matrix phi theta psi, so my Euler rotation matrix, to transform from the frame x, y, and z R0. So here is a weight in R0, and here it is in R1. That's why I need this rotation matrix. Plus, so concerning the forces, I can consider that my propellers are expressed naturally in the robot frame. That's why here I will have 0, 0, tau 0. But since tau 0 is normally oriented upward, I will have to put minus because the z is oriented downward. That's why this equation I have here, if I isolate this one, so m will be cancelled here and will be here, this is why I obtain all this, okay, which corresponds to AR. Okay, now I need to prove, I have proved the three first equation. I need to prove the last one, and the last one corresponds to the Euler rotation equation. The Euler rotation, equation. It's very similar to the previous one, except that it is now for rotation. So it tells me that the acceleration with respect to the rotation, so the derivative of the rotation vector. Here it's not the mass, it is the inertial matrix. So similar to the mass. Plus, so it's a little bit more complicated than the previous one, I have to add this effect, E omega r, still the inertial matrix, it equal, it's not the force here, it is theta r, so r means in the robot frame, because I express both relation in the robot frame, and in my situation, it will correspond to the torque because of the rotation, and it is T0, T2, T3. Recall that T1, tau2, tau3, and tau0 was for the translation, not for the rotation. That's why now, if I isolate this one, then I will obtain this equation, which corresponds to the Euler rotation formula. So now I have obtained all the state equation of my quadrator, and I will be able to simulate it. So in my program, I will replace my evolution f of x by this new one, which corresponds to what I have just written at the moment. So this one, first I called my vector capital X to avoid the confusion with X, Y, and Z. I have my three Euler angles, so it corresponds to the six first components of my state vector. I also take the speed in the robot frame, the rotational speed omega r. I take the algebraic square of w, with w is the input of my system and corresponds to the rotational speed of each blade. I transform thanks to my matrix B I have obtained before, and I obtain T0, T1, T2, T3. I compute my Euler matrix to change frame. I compute here the cross product to compute the derivative of VR. The same here for P. The same also with the derivative of Euler angle. And I compute this matrix, which is given in Roblib. So in Roblib, recall that I have all tools I classically use, and this one is used for any 3D robot. And I stack all these vectors, and I obtain the derivative of x I will use to in the Euler formula to obtain the evolution of my function. Also, in my quadrirotor, as given in Roblib, I am able to put an angle, so a vector alpha, which corresponds to the four angles of the blades. So in quadrotor, in Roblib, I have alpha, so which looks here like a, but it is alpha. It is a vector four dimension, and which allow me to draw the blades. So that's why if I want to make them turning for more realism, I first initialize them alpha to zero. It means all my blades at are at zero. And I will increase them by some kind of Euler formula, which tells me that alpha equal alpha plus dt times the rotational speed omega. So omega is not computed yet. I will have to get them. So omega will be obtained by a controller. So I will omega is equal to controller will give it to me. So I will call it control. I have not yet programmed the function, but I will the controller will need x as an input. Def controller. I will do something very simple at the moment. I will put capital X also for. I will return. So return a simple vector, which tells me, for instance, that I will return an array. Okay, I need four components because I have four blades. I will put some rotation, let's say for instance 5, 5, 5 and 5. So all blades turn at the same value. I will have to initialize also my inertial matrix, which has not done yet, so I will do it here because which corresponds to an array. Corresponds to an array with three lines. The first line will is given in the exercise. So in the exercise, I give the inertial matrix and also the mass and all these quantities. So I will enter them now. So I will have 10, 0, 0. Whoop, excuse me. Here, 0, 10, 0. And here, 0, 0, and 20. That's what is given for initial matrix. I have m the mass j that are given, b drag coefficient, and they are given by 10, 9, 81. I will put it t. I need d delta, which corresponds to delta. I correct some error. Here, comma. W is missing. Here, I need also L. The length is corresponds to 1 meter in the exercise. I don't need it anymore here. I start the program. And we can see the quadrotor goes going up. I will take some smaller, let's say 0.01. So I will go slower, and I will change, instead of taking this, I will put the first propeller going faster, 6, just to see what happened. I start. We can see the blades are turning, we can see here. All of them, this one goes faster, and the quadrotor turns like this. And there is also some other unexpected rotation corresponding to the drag effect, the counter effect of the fact that the quadrotor will turn on the opposite direction to the blade. Okay, so the simulation of the quadrotor seems to work quite well. We'll be able now to go to the control. The state equation of the quadrotor corresponds to a causal chain, so a sequence of systems which interact in a sequential way. So the rotational speed of the blades will create some forces and some torques, so tau zero, tau 1, tau 2, tau 3. These torques will create some, will modify the rotational speed. The rotational speed will modify the Euler angle. The Euler angle, as well as tau zero, will create some modification of the speed vector. And the speed vector will create some modification of the position. So there is some kind of sequence from the rotational of the blades up to the position of the robot. And this will be used for the controller using a technique which is called the backstepping method. So we use a causal sequence in order to control the system. So let me explain this. If I consider a system like this, a sequence of system. So a system has some inputs like this. Let's say U1, U2. And we'll create something like A1, A2. A1 will go further, and A2 will, for instance, influence this system. And all of them will modify another systems, and so on. Okay, so we can see there is some direction in the causality. This direction, so it's what we call a causal sequence. Okay, so all this correspond to the system, so to our quadrotor. So the idea of backstepping is to create as a controller, so the controller will be, for instance, here, will create U1, U2, and the first idea is to invert the first subsystem. So this one will be such that in the controller I will have something A1, so similar to A1. I will call it like this. It's not exactly A1, but the idea is to make them the same. So if I take this system, it should be almost identity. So A1 will correspond to A hat 1, A2 to A hat 2, and so on. So in some sense, this one, so this subsystem 1, this one is the inverse of subsystem 1. Okay, and so on. So we'll do this, and then we'll inverse the second one, like this, and so on. And at the end, we expect that what we want here, if here is Y1, Y2, the output, what we want here, one desired, two desired, corresponds to what we have. So this should correspond to identity. Something like identity, it is the idea. In our context, the first subsystem corresponds to this one, S1. I will call it this matrix B. And S1 has an input omega, which is of dimension 4, and as an output, the force and the torque. So in this case, it's quite easy to inverse. So the system I will put here as an inverse. Will be omega equal. So I will take this matrix B. I will invert it. I will multiply by tau 0, tau 1, tau 2, tau 3. I will take the square root, so the algebraic square root of this vector. So what is the algebraic square root? So I put A to say that it is algebraic square root. The algebraic square root of, let's say, the vector 9 minus 16, 2 will be the vector 3 minus 4, 2, square root of 2. Okay. You can see that even if it is negative, the algebraic square root make me possible to obtain the square root. So if I do this, then this system will have as an input tau 0 and tau 3, and as an output tau 0, tau 3, so they are a little bit different, so even if it is almost equal to identity, I will put D because it means desired. So it means if I put this system in front of the our carburetor, if I want this value for tau, then thanks to this system I have added, I will obtain what I want for the torque and the forces without taking care of the rotation speed. And I will do this step by step. So now I will try to inverse this system. What we have done corresponds to the question one, where we have proposed a feed-forward controller with the input corresponding to the force and torques I want, and which eliminate the first block. Now, of course, it will be done after for the second block and so on. So let me implement this. Here the control will be different. Instead of ask the control, here was only to ask the speed for the blades. Now I will do something like this. I will return W, and W will correspond to the inverse of the block one. It's what I have done before, but now I will have to put this one outside this loop, so the way the procedure will not understand. It becomes a global variable, and then I will have to compute before two desired equal, and this one also I will have to compute it before. But at the end of the controller, the two lines I have correspond to the inverse of the first block, and that will be build the required speed for the blades, and as an input I will have to say what I want, and I will have to fill this line, of course. Let me come back here. So this this block will eliminate the first one, and now I will my quadrirotor may correspond to this block. So I will move it like this to isolate it. Like this. And now I can think that it corresponds to desired, and so on. Desired. So I will try to eliminate this block. So I will propose a controller. Here, which will be the inverse of this block? If I call it this one, to 1, 2, 3, desired. I can choose it as I want, since it is the input of my system. I will choose to 1, 2, 3 desired equal. So first I want to eliminate this part, so I will choose omega r e omega r, so that I eliminate this one, plus a coefficient, let's say k omega, multiply by omega r d minus omega r. So omega d is a new input for my system, omega. And this will correspond to this, in fact, will be inside this. We'll compute the vector, this vector, with respect to what I want. So, if I take this equation, I have omega dot r equal, so because of this is given by this, this will be eliminated by this, then here I have the identity here will be eliminated by this one, and I will obtain omega dot r equal to kw multiplied by omega r d minus omega r. It means that if this coefficient is strong enough, so I, it's a I coefficient, if it is I enough, then very quickly this will converge to this, so it means that this error corresponds to zero. So what I can say is that this system given here will correspond to the inverse of this system, and these two will eliminate, and omega r here will correspond to omega desired. So I have simplified this system with this system. So what we have done here is correspond to this line, inverse of block 2, where the coefficient, I took it large, 200, it could be something else, but it should be large, so that I can consider that at each time t, the true rotational speed wr corresponds to the one I want. Of course, before I will have to write wdr equal, and I will have to fill this one. Now I continue. The question was the following. I will have to invert the new block corresponding to the Euler angle. I mean, I want the quadrator as exactly the Euler angle phi theta psi, the one I want. First, recall that we have proposed a block here where I put 1, 2, 3, the one I want, and this one is supposed to cancel this one, okay, to produce this one, which is similar, almost equal to this one, okay. Now, I have another block. What I have done about this block, I proposed here another controller where I put here as an input WR desired, and this corresponds to the inverse of this one, so this one cancel this one. So I can consider that this quantity is equal to this quantity. Now, I am here in a context where I have the rotational speed I want, and I will want now to find a system here which will be the inverse of this system. So I want to fit it with Euler angle I want, so phi theta psi, the one I want, and this system will, since it is the inverse of this one, it should eliminate the second one. So in this case, what should I do? I will call it this matrix. Let's say this matrix, I will call it, let's say, T. And I will take W R desired, since I choose it as I want, equal to some coefficient, so big coefficient, multiply, so I will eliminate t, multiplied by the inverse of t, multiply by phi theta psi desired, minus phi theta psi that I measure. And if I do this, clearly, this block will eliminate this one. Let me check this. So I will have, thanks to this phi dot theta dot phi dot psi dot equal this, the t here will be eliminated by this one, k, which is this one, multiply by phi d minus phi, theta d minus theta, psi d minus theta, the psi. So if this one is large enough, I will have a quick convergence of everything to zero. Also, to avoid the 0-2p problem, this error should be filtered by the sawtooth function, so that an error of 2pi will correspond to an error of 0. And I can now implement this. So I will omega dr, the inverse, which corresponds to this. This corresponds to t. This corresponds to the big coefficient. Oh, I took 5. I could take more. After it I have to take care because of the fact that I am simulating with a dt which is not equal to 0. No, not too small, not too big. I have to tune this. And the sawtooth function is here to avoid the O2π problem. So now, again, I will have to write this one equal. So if I want the robot to be flat at the horizontal, I put 0, 0, 0. And if I want a force to go upward, I put, for instance, 10. I will have now to extract the Euler angle from the state. So in this case, I can take from here all these things. So I will now, phi theta psi will be available. For later, probably I will need the Euler matrix also. P dot also, probably I will need it. I will start the simulation. And we can see that the robot is flat. Okay, it's going downward, but it's flat. The blade go also too slowly, so I will try to change different things. If I want first the blade to go faster, I will put something here, for instance, 50. I also want to see that my system is stable, so I will put at the beginning an angle phi equal to 1, just to see how it behaves, how it is controlled. And I will start again. Okay, so at the beginning there is some stabilization. Of course, it's going down, but it is at the horizontal, and we can see the blades turning. Here in black it is a shadow. So I'm going downward, because probably the force, vertical force, is not strong enough. If I want it to go upward, I will try to put something larger. For instance, 100. Okay, there is some stabilization. Not strong enough. Two hundred. Okay. So of course I will have to control the altitude. Here at this level it is not controlled, but I will have to control it. To control the altitude, I should put something here which depends on the altitude of the quadrotor and with the difference with the altitude where I want to be. So we can imagine that I am, the quadrotor is here at the altitude Z, and it wants to go to the altitude ZD. So remember that Z is oriented downward. The error here is positive. So if Z minus ZD, if this difference is positive, then of course T0 should be larger. So equal to a constant, and this constant should be large. Especially because the robot, due to the gravity, he naturally go downward. So I put just before 200. If I want to be more reactive, I could put something larger, for instance 300, but it has to be able to compensate easily the effect of gravity. So here I put let's say 300, and I put hyperbolic tangent for the saturation, because it's not because the error is large that I really want to be more reactive. If I do this, and if I ask, for instance, ZD, I ask for ZD to be equal to, let's say, 10, minus 10. It means 10 meters above the surface. I start. Okay, transition. And then it is flat, horizontal, and it will reach normally the altitude 10, and there is some oscillation. Of course, it go now, it will go down and so on. It will oscillate around the altitude of 10. That's why I need a derivative term. That's what I will do now, the derivative, to avoid this oscillation. So the derivative term is added by, I put a coefficient, let's say 50 or 60, whatever, multiplied by the horizontal speed, so VR, the third component, which corresponds to 2. If I do this, the derivative term will limit the effect of oscillation if this coefficient is strong enough. Otherwise, I will increase it. Okay, so let's have a look to the oscillation. It goes slowly upward, but after it may depends of the dt. Maybe I could increase it. Or it will be okay. It will reach to 10. I don't think it will oscillate. It's perfect. Okay, it's okay. Now, how to control the heading, desired heading psi d. So to see the problem, here I will give a speed to the robot. For instance, initial speed of minus 20, for instance, and I will start the program. Look what happened. The robot is starting, and the blue, which is supposed to be the front, is on the right. And if there is a camera on the blue, then I would like to see in front of me, not on my right. So I will have to control the heading so that the blue is always in front. So how can I do this? I have here my quadrotor, and it's, we can see that the camera is on the right and I want it on the in front. So I compute, this corresponds to my speed. Let's say I will call it V. And V corresponds to P dot. So what I want is that the heading Psi corresponds to the angle of P dot. For Psi D, I put angle of dp computed here. I run. Oop. And I see some chattering effect. So it happens when some coefficient is too strong, and especially when the discretization time is not small enough. So in this case, I have to reduce some gains. But we can see that the blue is in front now. So here, for instance, 200, I will put 100. Probably it will be enough. I start. Okay, it looks better now. So the blue is front. Now I will use the pitch, theta, to control the speed. Let me explain this. Here we can see a quadrirotor at the beginning. The speed is zero, almost zero, and we can see that it takes some pitch. So here the direction is x like this, the front of the quadrirotor, and we can see that it takes some pitch like this, theta. In this case it is negative, so that it will be able, due to the force tau zero, like this, it will, so tau zero will compensate the weight, but also the will contribute to move forward the quadrotor. So if theta is equal to zero, then the speed will not move. You can say that V dot equal to zero, okay? And so we will use theta in order to control the speed. So let me explain like this. Here we can see that x is front, Z is in this direction, Y like this, and we can see here that theta is negative and tau is like this. So the control we can take is theta, so theta desired, the one I want, I will be controlled around this one, will correspond to something which is the difference between the speed I want go and the speed VR with respect to X, the first component. So of course we don't want angles theta which are larger than let's say 0.5 or 0.3 or something like this. I don't want too much angle. That's why I need a saturation function, tangent hyperbolic, and then here I will take, for instance, 0.3 or 0.5 and a minus, because when theta is negative, I will move forward. In my program, I will change like this. If I take a speed at the beginning which is small, For instance, initial speed will be 0. I take something small, minus 0.3, let's say. And if I want to go to a speed of, let's say, 10, so I will put here V desired equal to 10. Then after some initial behavior, then we go straight and we can see that the blue is front, so it's good, and also it is the orientation, the pitch is negative, so that the robot can accelerate. Now we have to control the roll, VD. So to understand that how it has some consequence on the direction, let us ask, for instance, 0.5 for the desired roll. Let's see what happens. After the initial transition, we can see that the quadrotor is turning on the right. Okay, so if it goes slowly, it is because the time dt is small. But of course, it goes faster. So it turns on the right. So we'll try to find the right phi, the right roll, in order to go to the right direction. So it is a view of what happened. We have here x, and if I see, so from the back, I can see here the quadrotor with x, which is like this, and y, which is on the right, z, like this. So in fact, what happened is that tau is like this, tau 0, and from above, the component tau 0 is like this. So tau 0 from above, here we have z, x is like this, and y on the right. This is why the robot has a trajectory turning on the right. Assume that I want to go this direction, so let's say FD, and I'm going to this direction, so V, okay, which corresponds to VR, or which corresponds to P dot. Okay, we have two vectors. So everything is controlled. We are able to go to the right speed, with the camera in front, and we want to go to this direction, but we are going this direction. So we'll compute this angle. It will correspond to the error. So the error of angle, let's say it will correspond to error on psi, good, like this. It will be the angle of FD, the vector FD, minus the angle of P dot, let's say P dot. So if you want, it will be this angle minus this angle. And here I will have the error on C. So if I want to correct this, I would change the desired role, VD. So I will take this error and I will go to the sawtooth function to avoid the O2P problem of Ipsy. Okay, now I want it to go to a good precision. It's not one degree, but it can be something like this. And if I consider in gradient, probably I will have to increase this. I would put 10. So it corresponds to the precision. If I want to increase the precision of heading, I would change this one. And then this one, I will saturate it so that VD is always between, let's say, minus 1 and plus 1, thanks to the hyperbolic tangent. And if I want to minus 1 and plus 1 is maybe too much for have a good security of the robot, and probably I want something smaller, let's say 0.5. Okay. So if I do this, my robot will move, will turn, will take some roll in order to reach the direction FD. So let me try this. I do something like this, and FD will correspond to an array. And if I want to go to the direction 1, 1, for instance, I put 1, 2, whatever, initialize this vector. Angle is given in Roblib, use arctangent 2. I run it. After the initial transition, the robot will move towards the right direction. So the vector 1, 2. We follow the vector 1, 2. Okay, let's come back to the exercise. We want now to follow a vector field which is given here. It corresponds to the van der Poel equation. And after, the robot will follow this cycle, the well-known van der Poel cycle. So just before the control, I will enter the equation of the van der Poel cycle here, given in the exercise. And then here, I will put x and y, and I will ask for the F van der Poel VDP of this. Okay. Now, after initial transition, the robot starts from the center. Will go to the van der Poel cycle, and if we compute the whole trajectory, we get what is given in the exercise.